So hi everyone, a very good evening to all of you and welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In today's class, we'll be talking about the PIB news from second week of September 2024 and I hope the preparations for the phase 2 RBI and NABARD are going well. So chaliye start karte hain class ko and let's talk about the PIB releases, the Press Information Bureau releases from the month of September, the second week. The very first news is very, very important. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, the fourth edition. So the Union Cabinet has approved the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, fourth edition. And obviously it was proposed by the Ministry of Rural Development headed by Shivraj Singh Chauhan. All right. Now talking about the basics of this particular scheme. So the total outlay is 70,125 crores, out of which the central share will be 49,087.50 crores, and the state shares will be 21,037.50 crores. The duration of this particular scheme will be for the period of 5 years, starting from this financial year and ending in financial year 2029. Okay. Features ki agar hum baat kare, if we talk about the basic features of this particular scheme, so coverage 25,000 unconnected habitations. It was announced in the budget 24-25 as well, that 25,000 unconnected habitations will be connected with the pakka roads, will be connected with the roads. And these unconnected habitations must be of the population size 500 plus in plains, 250 plus in northeastern states and hilly states and UTs and special category states, right? And the population should be 100 plus. In LWE, that is left wing extremism affected districts, as per census 2011. So this is the coverage. Do remember the population criteria as well. 500 plus for plains, 250 plus for northeastern hilly states, UTs and special category areas. 100 plus is for LWE affected areas. Here, financial assistance will be provided for the total construction of 62,500 kilometer roads, right? And of course, isme ye bahut important cheez nikal ke aayi hai, that new technologies, international benchmarks and best practices, international benchmarks and best practices will be adopted, will be incorporated during the road construction, like cold mix technology and waste plastic, paneled cement concrete, cell filled concrete, full depth reclamation, use of construction waste and other waste such as fly ash, steel slag, etc. So basically new technologies will be adopted taki hum green roads ki taraf aage badh sake. Okay, so the fourth edition of PMGSY road alignment planning will be undertaken through the PM Gati Shakti portal. Okay, so basically iski jo planning plotting hogi wo sari PM Gati Shakti portal ke through ki jayegi. Question aapko khud hi solve karna hai. I hope Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana fourth edition is clear. Question aapko khud hi solve karna hai. I am not going to solve the questions for you. The next news is very, very important. Again, Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana has now been extended to all senior citizens aged 70 years and above, irrespective of their income status. I hope you guys know that Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana is only for economically weaker sections, right? Initially, it was launched for 10.74 crore poor households identified by socio-economic caste census. Later on, it was extended to other sections as well. But till today, it is only for the economically and socially weaker section. But now, irrespective of the income, the scheme has been extended to all senior citizens who are aged 70 years and above. And that is the news, and that is why it is in news. Now, this step will benefit approximately 4.5 crore families, with 6 crore senior citizens, or obviously in under Ayushman Bharat, 5 lakh free health insurance cover will be provided to all those senior citizens who are aged 70 years and above. Very important step taken by the government of India. Isme ek cheez hai jo ki dhyan mein rakhni hai. If any senior citizens who is already, if there is, let's say there is any particular senior citizen who is 70 plus, but this senior citizen is already a part of Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana through his or her family, then that senior citizen will get an additional top-up health insurance of 5 lakh per year exclusively for himself or herself. Okay? So family coverage se bilkul alag hoga. फैमिली कवरेज वाला 5 लाख है वो अलग है, उसके अलावा उस सीनियर सिटीजन को 5 लाख का कवरेज अलग से मिलेगा अंडर आयुष्मान भारत, राइट। नाउ व्हाट अबाउट दोस सीनियर सिटीजंस एज्ड 70 इयर्स एंड अबव हु आर ऑलरेडी एनरोल्ड इन अदर पब्लिक हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस स्कीम। सो इफ एनी सीनियर सिटीजन इज ऑलरेडी एम्पैनल्ड और एनरोल्ड इन अदर पब्लिक हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस स्कीम लाइक CGHS, एक्स सर्विसमैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटरी हेल्थ स्कीम, आयुष्मान CAPF, then they will have the option to continue with their existing scheme or they can also switch to the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. Okay, and not only this, even those covered under private health insurance or the employee state insurance scheme will be eligible for the benefits of Ayushman Bharat, right? And as you all know, Ayushman Bharat is world's largest publicly funded health insurance scheme. It provides health insurance cover of 5 lakh per family per year for secondary and tertiary care hospitalization to 55 crore individuals corresponding to 12.34 crore families. These two numbers are important and that is why I am talking about these numbers. Now the scheme has so far covered 7.37 crore hospital admissions including 49% women beneficiary. And the public has benefit to the extent of over 1 lakh crore under this particular scheme. 1 lakh crore se zyada ka fayda abhi tak mein Ayushman Bharat ke through sarkar ne logo tak pahunchaya hai. Theek hai? Isse pehle initially the scheme was for 10.74 crore poor and vulnerable families, right? Identified from SECC. Then the government expanded the base to 12 crore families considering India's decadal population growth. And then later on, it was expanded to cover 37 lakh Asha workers, Anganwadi workers and Anganwadi helpers as well. And now it has been extended to 70 plus senior citizens as well. Okay, I hope it is clear. Question aapko khud hi solve karna hai. Now the next news is about PM e-bus Seva Payment Security Mechanism Scheme. I hope you guys remember that we have already discussed PM e-bus Seva Scheme. Now, under PM e-bus Seva, there is new mechanism that is payment security mechanism that has been approved by the Union Cabinet. Now, why it has been done? For procurement and operation of e-buses by public transport authorities. Public transport authorities dwara e-buses ko procure aur operate karne ke liye aisa kiya gaya. Theek hai? Now, iski zarurat kyun padi? Uske liye hame thoda sa background mein jaane ki zarurat hai. So, dekho, now, right now, all the public transport authorities, all the buses which are being operated by public transport authorities run on either diesel or CNG. Obviously, this contributes to the environmental pollution. Now, e-buses obviously are environment friendly and they also have a lower operational cost as well. Okay? Environmental friendly bhi hai aur operational cost bhi kam hai. Okay? Now, that is why through this payment security mechanism scheme, the government intends to promote public-private partnerships so that the public transport authorities can operate the e-buses and procure as well. Okay, so the PPP model kya hoga wo? To address the high capital cost. Ab dekho, jo public transport authorities hai, wo e-buses kyun nahi lete hai? Because uska cost zyada hai, uski purchasing cost zyada hai, procurement cost zyada hai, aur uska operating cost jo hai wo operating cost although kam hai, lekin wo chahenge ki bhai hum अलग से अब क्यों इसमें खर्चा करें, हमारे पास तो डीजल और सीएनजी की बस है. ठीक है, सो टू एड्रेस द हाई कैपिटल कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोक्योरिंग ई बसेस पीटीएस विल अडॉप्ट अ पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप मॉडल, राइट. पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप मॉडल के थ्रू जो पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट अथॉरिटीज हैं वो ई बसेस को प्रोक्योर करेंगी. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट विल बी द रोल ऑफ पेमेंट सिक्योरिटी मैकेनिज्म हियर. तो देखो यहाँ पे होगा क्या, अभी तक जो पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट अथॉरिटीज है वो क्या करती हैं, वो बसेस प्रोक्योर करती हैं बट वो क्योंकि लॉस में चल रही होती हैं तो वो पैसा नहीं दे पाते, राइट. व्हाट इज द करंट सिचुएशन, व्हाट इज द करंट चैलेंज दैट ऑपरेटर्स इज द व्हाट द करंट चैलेंज ऑफ द ऑपरेटर्स ऑफ द और द ओरिजिनल इक्विपमेंट मैन्युफैक्चरर्स व्हिच मींस द मैन्युफैक्चरर्स ऑफ द बसेस इज द कंसर्न ओवर पेमेंट डिफॉल्ट्स फ्रॉम पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट अथॉरिटीज. जो पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट अथॉरिटीज है सारी लॉस में चलती हैं, DTC हो गया या BSES है, नॉट BSES जो बॉम्बे की है BSE, वो सब लॉस में चलते हैं तो इनके पास पैसा नहीं होता है किस चीज़ के लिए, प्रोक्योरमेंट के लिए प्रोक्योर कर लेते हैं पर पैसा नहीं दे पाते. नाउ थ्रू दिस PM e-bus Seva PSM स्कीम The government intends to address this challenge by setting up a dedicated fund to ensure timely payments to the original equipment manufacturers or the operators. Right. So in case any public transport authority defaults on the payments, then the payment to the operator will be given by the Convergence Energy Services Limited, which is the implementing agency of this particular scheme. And jo fir Convergence Energy Services Limited hai, wo baad mein public transport authority se paisa vasoolega. Theek hai ji, I hope the mechanism of the scheme is clear. So ab is scheme ke bare mein basic baatein hai wo bata deta hu. To facilitate the procurement and operation of e buses by PTAs, the outlay will be 3435.33 crores. Total more than 38,000 e-buses will be deployed in the period of financial year 24-25 to financial year 28-29. And the operation of e-buses will be supported for a period up to 12 years from the date of deployment. And as we already discussed, the implementing agency will be CESL, which is part of Energy Efficiency Services Limited. Okay, ji? I hope this scheme is clear. Question aapko khud se hi solve karna hai. Now another very important news, that is PME drive scheme. आपने FAME scheme का नाम सुना होगा और FAME scheme के बारे में आपने ये भी सुना होगा, हमने पढ़ा था कई बार, that FAME का जो second edition है वो end हो गया है, FAME 2. अब FAME 3 की जगह इन्होंने उसका नाम change करके ये launch कर दिया है, जिसका नाम है PM Electric Drive Revolution in Innovative Vehicle Enhancement, that is PME drive. Features almost same है, थोड़ा बहुत ऊपर नीचे किया होगा, but that is not a significant change, but ye hai FAME hi aur kuch nahi. Theek hai, naam change karke inhone launch kar diya FAME 3 ki jagah, nayi scheme dikha di ki bhaiya dekho humne nayi scheme launch kari hai. But I believe, in my opinion, it is not a new scheme, it is only an extension of FAME. Theek hai, but theek hai, with a new name of course. So PM electric drive revolution in innovative vehicle enhancement, PME drive is the name of the scheme, and it has been proposed by obviously the Ministry of Heavy Industries, because FAME scheme was also implemented by the Ministry of Heavy Industries only. Okay, so PME drive scheme kya hai bhai? To expedite the adoption of electric vehicles by providing upfront incentives for their purchase. Yahi FAME mein bhi hota tha, jab hum electric vehicle khareedte the to hame incentive milta tha, subsidy milti thi kuch na kuch. Theek hai, as well as by facilitating the establishment of essential charging infrastructure for EVs, which is a very big concern as of now, because the country, the consumer is purchasing electric vehicles, but there are not enough charging facilities in the country, and which is a very big problem. Ab electric vehicles mein aisa bhi nahi hota ki petrol hota hai ya CNG hota hai, wo to sirf electricity se chalta hai. To agar koi long route pe jana chahe electric vehicle se to nahi ja sakta, right? Local ke liye hi hai wo. The total outlay is 10,900 crores. The duration will be 2 years, and now there will be there are a number of components under this particular scheme. Number one is subsidies and demand incentives. Total 3679 crores has been allocated as demand incentive for various electronic vehicle segments like two wheelers, three wheelers, ambulances and trucks. Okay? Total deployment of 24.79 lakh two wheelers, 3.16 lakh three wheelers and 14,028 e-buses. Okay. Now there will be e-voucher system. E-voucher system has been introduced for the buyers to make for making this subsidy thing hassle free. So e-voucher system mein kya hoga? At the time of purchase of electric vehicles, what will happen? The scheme portal will generate an Aadhaar authenticated e-voucher for the buyer. Theek hai? Scheme portal kya karega? Aadhaar authenticated e-voucher create karega. A link to download the e-voucher shall be sent to the registered mobile number of the buyer. सबसे पहले क्या हुआ? Electric vehicle आप खरीदने गए, scheme portal ने क्या करा? Generate करा एक आधार authenticated e-voucher. ठीक है? उसको download करने का link mobile पे आ जाएगा. ठीक है? Buyer के. This e-voucher will be signed by the buyer and submitted to the dealer to avail demand incentive under the scheme. Buyer जो उसको sign करके dealer को दे देगा और dealer उसको incentive दे देगा. ठीक है? और dealer फिर dealer उसको साइन करके अपलोड करेगा पीएमई ड्राइव पोर्टल पे, और जो सब्सिडी डीलर ने बायर को दी है वो फिर डीलर जो है सरकार से ले लेगा. ठीक है? द साइंड ई वाउचर शैल बी सेंट टू द बायर एंड डीलर थ्रू एन एसएमएस. इट विल बी एसेंशियल फॉर ओईएम टू क्लेम रीइंबर्समेंट ऑफ डिमांड इंसेंटिव अंडर द स्कीम. ठीक है? crore rupees have been allocated for e-ambulances, for deployment of e-ambulances, right? The performance and safety standards of e-ambulances will be formulated in consultation, obviously, with the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, right? 4391 crores will be provided for procurement of 14,028 e-buses for public transportation, right? This deployment of public buses, public e-buses, will be done in 9 major cities with population over 40 lakhs, which are Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Ahmedabad, Surat, Bangalore, Pune and Hyderabad. Okay, the demand aggregation will be done by Convergence Efficiency Services Limited in the 9 cities. Okay. Total 500 crores have been allocated for deployment of e-trucks, and incentives will be given to those who will have a scrapping certificate from the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Okay. And now, talking about the charging infrastructure, so this particular scheme seeks to address the issue of electric vehicle buyers by promoting the electric vehicle charging stations, right? The scheme has proposed the installation of 22,100 fast chargers for four wheelers, 1,800 fast chargers for e-buses, and 48,400 fast chargers for electric two-wheelers and three-wheelers. The total outlay for this component only will be 2,000 crore, which means 2,000 crores will be used for installation of, or for deployment, or for construction of electric vehicle charging stations. Okay. And testing agencies will also be upgraded with a total outlay of 780 crores. Okay. I hope, guys, this scheme is clear. Now let's move ahead to Swachhta Hi Seva 2024 campaign, which is every year launched on the occasion of Prime Minister Modi's birthday. That is on 17th of September, and it continues till 2nd of October, that is Gandhi Jayanti. So this year also it has been launched by the Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation under the Ministry of Jal Shakti and the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. The theme for this year is Swabhav Swachhata Sanskar Swachhata, right? The three key pillars of this particular campaign is cleanliness target units, that is Shramdan activities, which is focused on time-bound transformation of specific target units and overall cleanliness. Swachhata mein jan bhagidari, that is public participation, awareness and advocacy, and Safai Mitra Suraksha Shivirs, that is providing preventive health checkups and social security coverage for sanitation workers. The duration I already told you, 17 September to 2nd of October 2024. Now the next news is Bhaskar Portal. What is Bhaskar Portal? Bhaskar stands for Bharat Startup Knowledge Access Registry, right? Bharat Startup Knowledge Access Registry Portal is the full form of Bhaskar Portal, and it has been launched by DPIIT, which works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Okay, under the Startup India program. Okay, so kya hai iske bare mein baat karte hain. So through this portal, the Ministry of Commerce and Industry intends to build the world's largest digital registry for stakeholders within the startup ecosystem. Now this platform has been designed to centralize, streamline and enhance collaboration among various key stakeholders within the entrepreneurship ecosystem, right? And they will come together to create world's largest digital registry for stakeholders within the startup ecosystem. Okay, these are the key features: networking and collaboration, providing centralized access to resources, creating personalized identification, enhancing discoverability and supporting India's global brand. ठीक है, इनको डिटेल में ज्यादा याद करने की आपको जरूरत नहीं है. जस्ट रिमेंबर दीज आर सम ऑफ द की फीचर्स ऑफ द भास्कर पोर्टल. तो बेसिकली भास्कर पोर्टल इज अ पोर्टल विच विल गिव अस द वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट डिजिटल रजिस्ट्री फॉर स्टेक होल्डर्स विद इन द स्टार्टअप इकोसिस्टम. इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय डीपीआईटी, डिपार्टमेंट फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्री एंड इंटरनल ट्रेड, विच वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री, राइट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट न्यूज इज 4 years ऑफ प्रधानमंत्री मत्स्य संपदा योजना. सो Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana, which was launched in financial year 2021, has completed 4 years of its successful implementation, right? And on the occasion of the fourth anniversary of this particular scheme, some new initiatives have been launched by the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, right? And what are those initiatives? NFDP, National Fisheries Development Program Portal, has been launched and the operational guidelines for Pradhan Mantri Matsya Kisan Samriddhi Sahayojana has been launched. SOPs have been launched, standard operating procedures for production and processing clusters under the Fisheries Cluster Development Program have been launched. Okay. Now, guidelines to develop 100 coastal villages into climate resilient coastal fishermen villages have been launched with an allocation of 200 crore rupees. Right? Drone technology pilot has been launched for using drone technology for fish transportation, and this will be conducted by Central Inland Fisheries Research Institute. Right? Now, nucleus breeding centers for marine and inland species will be set up with ICARCIFA, which is Central Institute of Freshwater Agriculture, Bhubaneswar, and ICAR, Central Marine Fisheries Research Institute, Mandapam, which is designated as Nodal Institute for Freshwater and Marine Species respectively. Basically, nucleus breeding centers will be set up for marine and inland species with ICAR, CIFA, and ICAR, CMFRI. Okay? And three incubation centers will be established to promote 100 fisheries startups, cooperatives, FPOs, and SHGs. Right? Now, what is the contribution of fisheries sector in the economy? Ye bhi aap logo se pucha ja sakta hai. So, fisheries sector support around 30 million people, especially from marginalized communities. Fish production of 175.45 lakh tons was there in the last to last financial year, that is 22-23. India is the third largest fish producing country in the world. And the fishery sector contributes about 1.09% to the country's GVA and over 6.724% to the agricultural GVA. Right. For FIDF, launched in 2018-19 with a total fund size of 7522.48 crores. This, I believe you guys know, and Kisan credit card has been extended for the fishermen as well. Okay? Now, iske baad guys, other important question hai, jo ki main aapko padke obviously nahi sunaunga. You guys can yourself read these questions from this particular PDF aur uska solution bhi diya hai aur explanation jahan jahan pe zarurat hai, wahan pe explanation bhi given hai, like here. Okay? Now, I am just not going to waste your time by just reading these questions and telling you the answer without any explanation. So you guys can yourself read these questions from this particular PDF. Alright. I hope you guys have enjoyed this class, and I will see you in the next class of third week of September 2024. And for 2025 and for every exam, we will be starting from the month of October 2024. Till then, keep studying and keep studying hard. I will see you in the next class. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.